Each ascendant beacon you reawaken reclaims a road once lost to me, broadens my sight. But my realm still aches. Savathun has done so much to destroy everything my people worked for. She stole my brother from me, twisted his mind, and delivered him to his executioners. Then she had the audacity to steal him from the Traveler, manipulate him, and lead him back home. It is strange, having him here. And yet not. Pro is a wounded bird, flinching away from me, so much like Uldren, but lost without a guiding hand. Do you understand why I forbade him from speaking with Savathun? This reunion is such cruel kindness. I will find a way to repay her for it, and you will continue to bring me the Techians I need to do so.
Much loved by the flock, convinced a great many to fly with the twins when they left the hollow, he knelt before Riga and presented the crown of feathers their mother had crafted for her, and waited for her to respond in kind. She rose as queen, but did not gift Ager the scepter. His scepter. Despite everything, she still said he wasn't ready. It was a test of his will, right? His devotion, one he would not fail, for he was patient so patient. Together, the twins led the flock away from the oak's hollow to carve new nests in distant boughs beyond the forest's edge. Ager flew far and wide at Riga's behest, always thinking of her test, and returned home with tales of all that he had seen. Dark clouds surrounded them. Fires burned within trees, split by thunderous bolts. His twin kept his words close. Riga scattered prophetic bones and traced their curvature like weathered oaken bends. In them, the signs were clear. A great storm did indeed approach, they in its path. And so they prepared themselves for war. I wish you'd just give it to me. I could use it to help us face what we both know is coming. It doesn't even belong to you.
This coming storm he speaks of was the flashpoint. The battle of Saturn against the Taken King. It was the shift from stability into dissonance. I failed to shape Uldren in accordance with my goals, but if I were to take all that he was and reveal that past to him now, would he be my brother? Or is it only his echoes that remain? I see many of those same beginnings leading now to different ends. Tell me, would you be so forgiving if Crow carried more of Uldren with him? Would you still accept him? A defensive ward has been engaged over the Scepter. It is a failsafe to keep it protected. Either my brother found this place without my knowledge and set it off, or the ward was engaged when the surrounding architecture suffered structural damage. There is a bypass. It is code, kept secret, in that it has been scattered across dozens of terminals throughout the Awoken territory. Fret not, you don't have to collect them. I will have the pieces consolidated and reformed. While you wait, you needn't stand idle like a lost child. Return to me. My borders are threatened. My coven grows daily.
But we must hold the blind well a while longer.
Between our light and your mystical knowledge, we're pretty unbreakable. Right, cousin?
I'm not your cousin, Lightbearer.
Are the ley lines natural phenomena, or something the Awoken created?
They're naturally occurring paracausal forces that predate the Awoken. The only entities that might know their true origin and makeup are the Nine. But I don't think they're telling.
The Scorn can't poison the ley lines without it. Scans show that this sector is clear. Unfortunately, Zivor Roth's forces are already amassing elsewhere.
As long as we have Savathun, she won't stop coming.
Queen Mara, if your ritual goes according to plan, what will happen to Savathun?
Without her worm, she'll be powerless.
That seems like a waste. Imagine how much intel she could provide.
To us? Or to you?
Bank the taken essences to close their rifts and stabilize the area.
Shut down the taken rifts and the ley lines are stabilizing. But until we reassemble Queen Mara's coven, we're just plugging leaks.
Scorn inbound, Guardian.
Better keep your compass safe.
Mystic adventures among the stars. Remember, Crow?
They were only stories. It passed the time.
You wrote them down like in a book. I always kept the pages on you so Spider wouldn't find them.
Glint, enough.
My brother was a storyteller, too. He spun the most fabulous fables for our people's children. I have copies in my library, if you like.
That won't be necessary.